Alrighty, it felt so good to get the drone up again. It's been so long, and it actually took me an hour and a half to reprogram my drone today. Literally, I went to go fly first thing in the morning, and I was like, it had two updates to install. I haven't flown it in so long. And then I had to reformat the SD card. It was just a whole hot mess. Anyways, I finally got it up, and it was absolutely phenomenal. The cloud coverage, the partial cloud coverage, provided the best lighting for filming. I was so impressed with how this footage turned out. It looks like I'm right up close, and I promise you I am not. Again, the drone that I use is a DJI Mavic Pro, and it has a digital zoom, so it looks like I'm a lot closer than I actually am. So again, when flying drones, especially near a theme park or property, definitely ensure you are abiding by all the local laws. So I am flying over a field next to the park. I am not flying over the park at any point. So your drone should never pass over a person, vehicle, or building, which my drone does not do at any point. So put that aside. We got an awesome construction. So construction updates. As you can see, they loaded on the first piece of the lift hill to the truck that'll then bring it into the park. As you can also see, there's a bunch of yellow, what looks like support beams sitting in the parking lot, and you may ask yourself, what is that? Well, it is a crane. It is a very massive crane, and they are constructing it inside the park, which you'll see in just a bit. But as you can see, not much has actually changed in terms of track in this storage area. So if you actually look, it almost looks identical to what it did earlier on this week. So it looks like no new track has arrived other than you can see parts of the Immelmann loop sitting just off to the left side of the storage lot. But yeah, not too much new in terms of that, just the crane. The crane was all delivered today by the looks of it. As you can see, there's a truck leaving in this shot. But it is really sad that the park is closed. So a part of me was literally like, oh, I wish I was inside the park right now. I wish I was like, you know, filming. I miss it so much. But the drone looks like it'll actually do its job. I got so used to filming inside the park, I forgot how the channel started off of drone footage, and I also forgot how good the drone I use actually is. This is phenomenal, and especially when we get up there, it provides great context to the coaster's size and how it's going to play out. So in terms of filming this documentary that I'm going to be working on, this is going to be excellent for shots and footage that typically we don't always see for coaster construction projects. So I'm super excited about that. So I'm going to put that aside. As you can tell, the first support structure has been installed. It is sitting there. And as you can also see in the yellow parts of the shot, just up in the northern part of the construction site, you can see the crane being built. The crane came in completely different parts. The wheels came separately. The crane has come separately. They are literally building this crane as if it's like a building or a coaster per se. But yeah, super excited. I want to point out how steep this lift hill looks. This could be depth perception or just the angle and, you know, how it's being seen, but it really looks really steep. I was talking to my team and I was like, do you think that we could be looking at a steeper angle of ascent than 47 degrees? Maybe they had to really get this one in a tight fit, but there's one of the wheels, by the way. I know it's not a wheel. It's more like tractor treads or something like that. I have no idea. So correct me down below what the actual name for those wheels are and make fun of me if you want. But yeah, not much in terms of other activity going on. An excavator showed up next to Mindbuster, start playing the violin. I'm kidding. It's not going anywhere yet. Nor do I think the park is going to remove Mindbuster. I know I made a lot of videos on what's going to happen to Mindbuster, and those videos still stand because there's definitely a lot of weird activity. But construction's definitely going to be starting soon on the northern part of the coaster, the second half, per se. So that'll probably start shortly. I mean, this coaster's already miles ahead of where it should be at this time frame. They're about to get the lift hill installed. I mean, we are even looking at possibly the lift hill being completed by the end of the week, depending if those lift track pieces show up this week. If not, then I'm looking at probably the end of next week. Nonetheless, super exciting. Lots going on. I mean, the lift structure is already taking shape. There's only two more columns that need to go in. So there's the second A-frame support and then the column 7, the most important in terms of our reporting on the coaster. Column 7 will then go on. Column 7 is actually located in this shot up near that yellow crane installing the big yellow crane. So column 7 is just up near there. So super exciting. I definitely missed doing drone updates. So there will be lots of drone updates. In fact, weekdays will be drone updates moving forward. Enjoy the shots. I'm not going to talk through the whole clip. I'm going to let you watch the remainder. But there's lots of activity going on around Mindbuster even in these shots. So if you pay attention, you'll actually be able to make out some different activity. Like over there behind the kids' splash area, there's a smaller crane there as well. So definitely lots of weird activity going on in and around the park. Look at Mindbuster, look at the little kids' splash area, look at the cranes on the construction site and the actual coaster itself. Hopefully you guys really enjoy these drone updates moving forward, because that is what my channel is moving back into. It's almost like going back to our original roots. So that's why I put in the old intro, because I wanted to pay homage to what the channel started on. I know a lot of people really enjoyed those updates, and it's what has become of the channel. And I'm super excited and super thankful for how you guys helped grow this channel into a much bigger community than I could have even imagined when I started with like 50 subscribers way back in the day. Anyways, thanks so much for watching, guys. Thanks for being a part of this. Hopefully you really enjoy this footage. Smash that like button if you missed this drone footage. Hit subscribe if you haven't already and you're new to the channel. And share this video for others to see and watch. Anyways, thanks so much, guys, for watching as usual. And have a good one. Bye.